Well, well, well. What have we here? The media colluding with Obama's crooked DOJ to kill story about Bill Clinton and Loretta Lynch's spontaneous meeting on the tarmac, where they talked about their grandkids. We wish we could say we were shocked. A new email dump from the FBI via FOIA request by the ACLGA reveals what appears to be collusion between the media and the DOJ to squash the story about the 2016 meeting between Loretta Lynch and Bill Clinton on the tarmac in Phoenix, Arizona. Also, Comey reportedly said the FBI had no documents related to this meeting to fill a prior FOIA request. That apparently isn't true, given this new email dump. The right scoop? We have just obtained hundreds of pages in our ongoing investigation and federal lawsuit on former Attorney General Loretta Lynch's tarmac meeting with former President Bill Clinton while the Department of Justice, DOJ, and FBI had an ongoing criminal investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails. The results are shocking. Watch Lynch's explanation of her meeting with Bill Clinton on the tarmac. First, the Comey FBI lied to us. Last July, we sent FOIA requests to both the Comey FBI and the Lynch DOJ asking for any documents related to the Clinton-Lynch plane meeting. The FBI, under the then directorship of James Comey, replied that no records responsive to your request were located. The documents we received today from the Department of Justice include several emails from the FBI to DOJ officials concerning the meeting. One with the subject line flag was correspondence between FBI officials, Richard Quinn, FBI Media, Investigative Publicity, and Michael Carden, and DOJ officials concerning flagging, a story about a casual, unscheduled meeting between former President Bill Clinton and DAG. The DOJ official instructs the FBI to let me know if you get any questions about this and provides, OR talkers, DOJ talking points, on this. The talking points, however, are redacted. Another email to the FBI contains the subject line security details coordinate between Loretta Lynch, Bill Clinton. On July 1, 2016, just days before our FOIA request, a DOJ email chain under the subject line, FBI just called, indicates that the FBI is looking for guidance in responding to media inquiries about news reports that the FBI had prevented the press from taking pictures of the Clinton-Lynch meeting. The discussion then went off email to several phone calls, of which we are not able to obtain records. An hour later, Carolyn Pocomi of the Office of the Attorney General stated, "I will let Rubitsky know." Jim Rubitsky was the chief of staff and senior counselor to FBI Director Jim Comey. The information that was to be provided to Rubitsky is redacted. Also of note, several of the documents contain redactions that are requested per FBI. It is clear that there were multiple records within the FBI responsive to our request and that discussions regarding the surreptitious meeting between then AG Lynch and the husband of the subject of an ongoing FBI criminal investigation reached the highest levels of the FBI. However, on October 21, 2016, the Comey FBI replied to our legal demands that no records responsive to your request were located. This is in direct contravention to the law, and we are preparing further legal action to force the FBI to come clean and turn over all documents related to this matter to us in a timely manner. Second, the hundreds of pages of, heavily redacted, more on that below, documents paint a clear picture of a DOJ in crisis mode as the news broke of Attorney General Lynch's meeting with former President Clinton. In fact, the records appear to indicate that the Attorney General's spin team immediately began preparing talking points for the Attorney General regarding the meeting before ever speaking with the AG about the matter. Third, there is clear evidence that the mainstream media was colluding with the DOJ to bury the story. A Washington Post reporter, speaking of the Clinton-Lynch meeting story, said, "I'm hoping I can put it to rest." The same Washington Post reporter, interacting with the DOJ spin team, implemented specific DOJ requests to change his story to make the Attorney General appear in a more favorable light. A New York Times reporter apologetically told the Obama DOJ that he was being pressed into service to have to cover the story. As the story was breaking, DOJ press officials stated, "I also talked to the ABC producer, who noted that they aren't interested, even if Fox runs with it. 2 days after the meeting, DOJ officials in a chain of emails that includes emails to Attorney General Lynch herself stated that the media coverage of the meeting looks like all or most are Fox and that CBS just says a few lines about the meeting. Fourth, DOJ bureaucrats have redacted all the talking points, discussions of talking points, a statement on the meeting that was apparently never delivered because there was not enough media coverage on the meeting, and its substantive discussions with the FBI on the matter. They absurdly claim the deliberative process exemption to FOIA, which is only supposed to apply to agency rulemaking processes. The ACLJ won't stop until justice is served on this matter. Discussions about Attorney General Lynch's ethically questionable meeting with former President Clinton during her investigation into Hillary Clinton clearly has nothing to do with any rulemaking process. We will be taking these redactions back to federal court. The law is on our side. We will keep pressing on with our investigation of former Attorney General Lynch until we get to the bottom of this. Here's James Comey discussing the Lynch and Clinton meeting on the tarmac. Here is Loretta Lynch's testimony before Congress regarding her meeting with Bill Clinton.